I was impressed with that move you pulled. Bang.
Ladies, gentlemen, boys, and girls, children of all ages, it's me, it's G, it's Double MD, the undefeated, undisputed YouTube champion. That's right, it's the Maverick, Mark Daniels. Here's episode 73 of our Pokemon Mystery Dungeon DX Let's Play. And guys, if you missed last episode, we went to Magma Cavern for the potential last time. We did, I believe, 7 different missions there. We got a bunch of EXP for it. We are, I think, like 900 points away from the next rank. We'll look at that here in a minute. But we also recruited Steelix. Steelix was the last Pokemon we needed out of here. So really, there's no point in coming back in here unless... And I think there's a very small chance that this happens. But potentially, maybe we'll see a mission where there's a reward for a Pokemon that we need for our Pokedex. In which case, obviously, we would do it. But that's a very small chance. I don't think it's going to happen. So we're probably done with Magma Cavern forever. And potentially done with Southern Cavern as well. Because we can get Larvitar and Flygon in other dungeons. And we already have Shiny Shuckle. So, probably done with that dungeon as well, which is cool. Anyways, today, guys, let's do Lapis Cave. We just need Shiny Noctowl. I don't think we need any other Pokemon here, for evolution purposes even. Maybe we need Bagon for Shogun or something. I don't think we do, though. I won't check it till we recruit it. But the main objective here, guys, is to do these missions. We need a Cherry Berry, so we'll grab a Cherry Berry. I would love to get a Shiny Noctowl. We only have one shiny, and what are there, 27 shinies? Let me double check. I have my Google Docs here. 27 shinies, guys, and we only have one. We're 73 episodes in. 73, and we have one. One out of 27 shinies. I'm a little concerned about that. Anyways, let's jump into it. Let's grab that Cherry Berry. Yeah, guys, I'm a little nervous about it. to say the least. Alright, so we need a Cherry Berry, which I'm sure we have plenty of. I also kind of want another Inviting Orb just to be safe. Where, oh where? There it is. Okay, let's jump into it, guys. Depending on how much time we have left, we may do another short run somewhere. Even if it's just going into the unknown relic, grabbing 5 unknowns, and then escape orbing out. We'll see. We'll get there when we get there. Alright, so there's our client, Shuppet. We do have squad up, which does mean for every Pokemon in our party, we have a better chance of recruiting Pokemon. And it looks like we don't need X-ray specs for this dungeon, so that's good. We can keep the friend bow on at all times. That'll be handy. Double fire blast, double fun. We'll grab the Nidorino. Sorry, Nidorina. We actually don't need any more Nidorans. Like, we're all Nidorans are done. We've been done with them for a long time. Which is good. Another Nidorina, nice. And of course, if we see a monster house, we'll definitely go for it. Because that, you know, increases, like, we have a chance of getting the tough foe. So that increases our chance of, like, finding a shiny. We may try using a rare quality orb at some point. I mean, we don't have one on us right now. I think it's the rare quality orb. It's the one that makes it to where Pokemon spawn with like rare qualities. I don't know if that would actually increase our chances of seeing a tough foe, but maybe it will. I don't know. I also failed to mention this. At the top left, guys, you'll see that our current Pokedex count is 215 out of 472. That 472 number, of course, includes all the individual Pokemon in the Pokedex. Well, there's really no Pokedex, but each individual Pokemon we can recruit. Including the 28 different unknown and the 27 shiny Pokemon. So we're almost halfway there. I mean, well, Kinda. We're getting there, right? Another neat arena. I think we have room for one more Pokemon. Will it be another neat arena? It sure will be. Just an army of neat arenas. That's fine. Moving on to the next floor. Look at all these neat arenas, dude. This is what Ash must have felt like when he caught like all those Tauruses in the Safari Zone. I think he got them in the Safari Zone. Well, he caught a bunch of Tauruses regardless. I think it was in the Safari Zone. I don't know. It's been a long time since I've watched the anime. Like a long time. I kind of want to go back and rewatch it. I own all of like the complete first. I don't want to say first season because I'm not sure how it's split apart. But I have all of the like Indigo Plateau stuff, right? And then I also have all the Orange Island stuff. I have it complete. But I also kind of want to watch some of the other seasons of Pokemon as well. Someday, I'm gonna end up buying them all at some point, including all the movies. And I'll end up just binge watching them at some point. Oh my god. Should we do it? Just an army of neat arenas, man. I should probably let my teammates attack, huh? Yeah, actually, guys, I'm waiting for my last two Dragon Ball Super DVDs to get here. Actually, Blu-ray specifically, but we don't need a swap, do we? We can just pick it up. Pick it up. So after that, I'll have all of the all of Dragon Ball complete, including you know Dragon Ball, Dragon Ball Z, Dragon Ball GT, Dragon Ball Super, all of the movies and the TV specials that you can buy. I don't think you can get the. I think there's like a Goku Jr., Vegeta Jr. one from GT, but I don't think it's like available on DVD or anything. Maybe it is, but beyond that, I'll have everything. I have the History of Trunks, I have the Bardock's TV special, I have it all. I'm just waiting for the last two to get here. So once I'm done with that, which is why I even bring this up, I might start focusing on Pokemon anime. I haven't decided yet. I might start focusing on trying to complete that collection. There's a lot of anime I still need to get for my collection. One of the harder ones is going to be like Naruto. I want to get all of Naruto Shippuden. And then I guess eventually Boruto. You know, I haven't watched any Boruto yet. I want to watch it. I'm just kind of waiting until there's just like a ton of Boruto. And then I'm going to binge watch it. That's kind of my plan. I want to get all of Inuyasha. I haven't even started that yet. I want to get like all of the original Yu-Gi-Oh. I think it's split up into two seasons. I'm not sure. But you know what I'm talking about when I say the original like Yu-Gi-Oh, right? Like everything before GX, basically. I'd like to get like all of Digimon, or at least like the first few seasons. I want to get Full Metal Alchemist. I've never watched Brotherhood, but I've watched the original Full Metal Alchemist. Maybe we'll get both. I don't know. I do want to watch Brotherhood at some point. I heard it's really good. I heard it's better than the original Full Metal. If you've seen both, let me know which one you liked better. I'm trying to think. I want to get Toradora, which is a fucking hard one to find. And it's so expensive. Like right now there's like a copy on Amazon right now. Ooh, hold on. Double Noctowl. For Toradora, like $70. It's like I'm not spending $70 on that. It's like 20 was it like 20 episodes, 26 episodes, something like that? I can't justify spending $70 on it. At max, I would spend maybe 40 bucks. Maybe. Okay, I gotta hold up. I gotta turn these attacks off for a minute. It's a shiny. Okay. Whoo boy. Alright. Yo, these Nidorans have gotta stop. No, guys, stop, please. I wouldn't be so mad if they knocked this out. Please wake up, Charizard. Please wake up. Stop attacking! No! I'm gonna be so mad! Do this! Oh my god. We didn't get it anyways. We got the final attack off at least. So if you don't know, for us to be able to recruit a Pokemon, the Pokemon we're controlling has to be the one to knock it out for us to get the recruit. We did knock it out, but we didn't get it. Even with the Inviting Orb and all these additional Pokemon. Alright, so what I'm going to do here, I got to figure out which one of these fucking Pokemon is doing a thing where we can leap to attack. Because we can't be having that. Which one of you is it? You got to go. You don't have a rare quality, so it's not you. Not this one. This fucking one. Get this motherfucker out of here. How do I get rid of you? Can I get rid of you? Really, I can't get rid of you? Surely I can. Ah, here we go. Okay, I'm just making sure only one of them has it. Yeah, it's because it has that rare quality when it's gone. It almost ruined everything for me. I would have been so mad if those Nidorinas knocked out that shiny Noctowl. I would have been so fucking mad, guys. No. I don't care that it empowers you. I'm not wasting Reviver Seed on a fodder Nidorina. It's just not happening. Sorry, just not gonna do it. Alright. I don't remember what I was talking about before that. That was a roller coaster of emotions, for sure. Oh boy. I know we were talking about anime that I want to obtain. I was talking about Toradora. Now, Toradora is pretty expensive. What other anime that I haven't mentioned that I want to get the full complete collection of? I need to get the latest season of High School DxD. I have the other three. I want to get the full collection of Neon Genesis Evangelion. Physical copy of it. Sure. And then there's like ones like Mega Man NT Warrior. I want to get There's a bunch. There's a bunch that I need to get. I have a bunch, like, completed collections of just anime. But those are ones that I need to get and start working on. There's a lot there. Okay, it's just a regular Noctowl. That's fine. I'm not sure if we need a regular Noctowl, but maybe we do. I want to take advantage of this inviting orb as long as we can. That was the first shiny we've seen in a while, too. It's a damn shame we didn't get the Pokemon. We had the friend bow equipped, right? Yeah, we did. Okay. Just making sure. I'm still trying to think of other anime I want to pick the full copies up of. There's still a bunch more that I'm just not thinking of. Okay, another Noctowl. They're actually popping up pretty frequently. It's another normal one. Let me just double check to make sure we don't actually need regular Noctowl. We don't. Okay, I didn't think so, but I just wanted to double check before we moved up here and our teammates start knocking them out. So we've had what, four encounters on this floor? I'm not sure how long I can stay on these floors. In Blue Rescue Team, gusts of wind would start blowing, kind of like warning us that we're staying a little bit too long on this floor. And then eventually, like if we stay too long, it would kick you out of the dungeon. I'm not sure there's anything like that for this. But we actually we have a ton of apples. I was gonna say we don't have a lot of apples, but I am wrong. We have a lot of apples. We of course want to take advantage of this inviting orb as much as possible here. How much experience are we getting for knocking these Pokemon out? That has to be like a Golbat on the bottom right. Yeah, it was. Because the way that like they were able to fly on the water on the mini maps, I was like, that's got to be a Golbat. Okay, so here's the queue I was talking about. Okay. I'm not sure how many we can take in terms of the wind. So I guess we'll go ahead and move on. I won't use another Invine Orb unless we find another shiny Noctowl. There's Mankey. Yeah, we got a lot of Noctowl encounters there, so that's good. Those tough foes are worth a good amount of EXP as well. And of course, they can drop like good items and stuff. Now, the question is, should I stay on this floor for a while? Yeah, I mean, at this point, we're probably not gonna be able to do another dungeon since we spent so long on that floor. It's already 20 minutes in. So we might as well just kind of hang out for a bit, huh? I mean, we have a couple more missions to do. If I'm not mistaken, this is what, a 14th floor dungeon? So we're almost done with it. But not quite yet. I wish there's a move like Sweet Scent in this game that could like attract wild Pokemon to appear. Kind of like in like the regular Pokemon games. If you would use Sweet Scent, it would like force a wild encounter. But I guess that'd be too powerful, huh? Level floor. All right, so we have. Okay, so we have a Meryl. I don't. I'm pretty sure we don't need Meryl. Nope. Or Azumarill. We still need shiny Azumarill, but that's obviously not gonna be shiny Azumarill. All right, so let's see if this Noctowl is a shiny or not. We'll go ahead and drink this though. I'm sure somebody needs it. Double Fire Blast, double fun. We're full on teammates, right? No, we're not. Okay, cool. We are now, though. Tony Tangela. I couldn't tell if it was shiny or not. It's regular, okay. Let me make sure we don't need a shell gun, but I'm like 99.99999% that we don't. Yep, we're good. Double Fire Blast, double fun. Alright, at this point, we're just gonna go ahead and try to get through this dungeon, because we're getting close on time. But hey, at least we found one shiny Noctowl. We got a few runs. So I'll take that as a win, even though we didn't get the shiny Noctowl. Right, 12th floor. There's our Slugma that wants the Cherry Berry. Why don't we have a Cherry Berry? Did I fucked up? Dude! The Cherry Berry is right next to you, man! Did I still use the Cherry Berry to wake somebody up? I don't remember doing that, but it's possible that I did. There could be a monster house on the bottom right, but I doubt it. It's only three items. Yeah. Floor. It should be the final floor before the treasure room. It's a Numel. Let me check Numel out. We don't need Numel, and we already have a Numel 4 camera up. So, I think we're good to go, man. I'll tell you what, we'll stick around on this floor until we get hungry again, then we'll go ahead and leave. We got a pretty big belly on us there, 148. You know, we found the stairs. See if we can't get another Noctowl encounter. Is that another cherry berry? We got a Noctowl spawn. Alright, maybe it's shiny, maybe we'll get lucky. That means we can turn our teammates off for a minute. Nope, normal. Normal Noctowl. Double flame burst, double fun. Double fire blast, double fun. Maybe get one more Noctowl. We're getting close to the end here. I guess we'll go ahead and head towards the stairs. Alright, that is it. That wasn't the last floor. Whoops. This is the last floor. There's no prize floor. Okay. That makes sense. Alright. Obviously, we're not going to recruit any of these Pokemon. So, unfortunately, no new Pokemon for our Pokedex here. But hey, we did get a shiny Noctowl encounter. We got several Noctowl encounters in total, which is good. We got some missions completed. So you guys know the drill by now. We're going to turn in all these missions, do some item management, and then we'll go to the bulletin board, choose what we're going to do for next episode. I don't think we're going to rank up here. These missions are pretty low level. But it's going to be close, man. And at the very least, I think we'll be able to rank up next episode. I kind of want to get a shiny, man. I want to get a shiny before we do anything else. So we're probably going to do a dungeon where we can attempt to get a shiny. We'll see. Oh, baby, we're so close. Oh yeah, at the beginning of the episode I said we were going to see how close we were, I forgot. We'll check no at the end here. We were like 950 away, I think. So now, after doing those missions, we are 350 away. So I'm going to need about 350 to rank up. So let's see what happens. I think we can get a next episode, I do. We'll check the mail. And I guess we'll do some item management real quick. A superb gift. Some tickets to the Makuhita Dojo. Alright, so nothing really there. Okay. Alrighty, what we got going on here? We got plenty of apples. Plenty of worn berries. I can probably get rid of a couple of those. Kind of looking through the orbs here, see what we got going on. Okay. So this is what I was talking about. Using them will make it easier to befriend Pokemon that have rare qualities. Oh, I didn't know. Okay, so it's another... I think I've said this before. Can you stack these? I'm gonna quickly Google and see if there's an answer for that. Mystery Dungeon DX. Can you stack rare quality orb and inviting orb? Not finding a direct answer. It looks like False Swipe is used to recruit Pokemon as well. Excuse me. Okay, well, I didn't find a direct answer. But I did find out something interesting. False Swipe. Let's take a look at it. I'm sure we have one. Give me a minute here, guys. Interesting. Now, we are limited on who can use False Swipe. And I'm looking at the list that we have here. I'm not going to name them all. But we're not using any of the Pokemon that can. I don't know if we want to use a Pokemon that can. Alright, hold on. These Pokemon are high level, man. Yo, we can evolve a Koffing into a Weezing right now. Hold on. Hell yeah. We are making... Hey, guys, we're making progress on the Pokedex after all. We did it. Whoops. Pushed enter, hoping that I could just click OK from that, but it didn't do it. Instead, it moved it down. Anyways, we got Weezing. Let's see what else we got here that we can evolve. Tangela, we'd have to use crystals for, so we're gonna hold off on that. Goldene, do we have a Sea King yet? We don't, but we don't have multiple Goldenes. We'll wait. Murkrow. Numel, okay. It's another new Pokemon. So the reason why I came here to begin with was to look at our Pokemon's levels and see if there's a Pokemon that can learn False Swipe at a higher level. I could have just checked our Pokemon without going through here though. But that's okay because we're evolving some Pokemon, so it worked out, it worked out. Laron. Let me quickly check Laron. Yeah, so we need one for Aggron, so let's go and evolve it now. We still need Aron, by the way. We don't have an Aron yet. There's another new Pokemon to our living decks. Aggron, one of the coolest Pokemon of all time, if you ask me. Alright. We can go backwards here. Do we have multiple Verbavas? No. But if we get one, we can evolve this one into a Flygon. Snorunt. We don't have Glalie yet, but the one that we have is for Frostlass, so I'll wait until we get another Snorunt. I know I could change it, but I don't want to. Alright, that's cool. So we got a couple evolutions here today. Alright, I know this is a long episode, Jesus. Okay. Here I thought this was gonna be a really short episode. Okay, status. So we have Daya, our Groudon. Alright, so let's look at the False Swipe Pokemon again. So, Beedrill is one of them, 71. That's pretty good. We'll have to level up its stats, though, probably. Heracross, Scizor. Gallade, which we don't have Gallade just yet. We also got Pharaoh, Parasect, Krabby, Kingler. Absol would work. Absol's got to be up there in levels by now. That's only 59. Okay. Parasect's a little 60. Marowak 54. Pinsir's level 56. I guess we'll use Beedrill, huh? Man, that means we have to get rid of a Pokemon that goes with us, though. Alright, hold on. I think we have to go into the dungeon before we can teach it to move, though. Alright, so we're gonna give Beedrill False Swipe. Perfect. Okay. Alright, now let's check the bulletin board. I guess Beedrill's gonna be coming with us now. But I want to level up Ponamaru, so I might leave Umi back. And take Beedrill and Hanamaru. Alright, so what we got here? We got Remains Island. Let's do that. Grand Sea. We've got the Sky Tower one for now. Don't know if we'll do it though. Frosty Forest, we still need to do. Okay. So today's episode actually was a lot longer than I thought it would be. Frosty Forest, bonus chests and money. We still need Pilot Swine. We probably need two Pilot Swines. We know we need a Snow Runt. And that's probably it. We also need Shiny Spinda. Do we need Normal Spinda as well? Probably. We don't. Okay. I never did item management, but that's all right. We'll do item management at the beginning of the next episode. So next episode, guys, we're going to be doing Frosty Forest. Maybe we can get Shiny Spinda. We'll take Beedrill with us. We'll switch into Beedrill if a Spinda shows up. We'll use False Swipe. We'll use the Friend Bow. And that's what we're going to do. Thank you guys so much for watching. And until next time, I am the Maverick Mark Daniels. Bidding you farewell, peace, and one love. Bang!